Archimedes, a mathematician, physicist, engineer, inventor, astronomer, but also got killed because of his love for math. Let me explain. During the siege on Syracuse by the Romans during the Punic Wars, according to many stories, after the fall of Syracuse, a Roman soldier stormed Archimedes' place while he was thinking about a mathematical solution. The soldier was shocked when Archimedes ignored his threats, so he went and ended his life despite the Romans' instructions to spare Archimedes' life. Archimedes was one of the great thinkers that have ever lived, and there are many books and documentaries that talks about his life. But nah, that's too boring to go through. Today I bring you the story of Archimedes' last day from the manga Eureka, or Heureka in Japanese I guess, by the mangaka Iwaki Hitoshi, also the author of the famous manga and anime Parasite. Eureka tells the story of the Roman siege on Syracuse and the role that Archimedes played in it. With 6 chapters each averaging around 40 pages, it is a quick read. However, please note that if you choose to watch the rest of the video, spoilers will be included. If you wish to read the manga before continuing the video, please feel free to do so, and be sure to subscribe afterwards. We start our story in Rome, in the midst of the Second Punic Wars, and the Battle of Cannae, when Hannibal Gini's strategy gave the Carthaginians a perfect win over the Romans that shook the power balance in the region. A refugee from Syracuse named Epicute was impressed and enchanted by the genius of Hannibal, promised to go back to his origin country and rally the troops and the people there to stand with Carthage and annul its relationship with Rome. At that time, the kingdom of Syracuse was an allied independent region of the Roman Empire. There were some diplomatic issues between the two regions. Epicute and some undercover Carthaginian soldiers seized this opportunity to rally the people to revolt against Rome and stand with Carthage. The story now shifts from the political tension in Syracuse to Claudia, a citizen with the Roman parents, and her friend from Sparta, Damippus, who came to Syracuse to escape the mess that is happening in Sparta. We shift back now to the revolution that is happening in the town. Romans are being kicked out and kidnapped, so Claudia, to look for her parents, moved to the only safe place that hosted the Roman civilian in hope of finding them. And now, along with Claudia and Damippus, we meet the main person of this story, Archimedes, as he starts showing them his famous inventions, the Archimedes screw, also known as the hydrodynamic screw that basically works as a water pump. The sword of Rome. A high commander, Marcus, is starting his attack on Syracuse to take it back. And to do so, they choose the Naval Road, because it is closer to the heart of the city. And, to their surprise, they meet face to face with Archimedes' siege inventions. From the grappling hooks, to the claw of Archimedes, revolutionary inventions that withstand any attack on the city and reverse the scale of the war in favor of Syracuse. After the failure of the naval siege, the Sword of Rome gives the responsibility to the second in command and the governor of Sicily, Apis. Technically, Syracuse is part of Sicily, so Apis knows best how to break the siege and conquer Syracuse. So this time, the Romans are going to attack through the greatest weakness in Syracuse defense, the western gate through the fortress of Uliaros. When Epicutes heard of this, he went to Archimedes to ask him to teach them how to run his fortress defense invention, the automatic catapult, or what he calls the wheel of Uliaros. Archimedes accepts to help them and send Damippus the Spartan to teach the army how to use his invention. But through Archimedes' panels and speech, we see that he does not care who's attacking. He just cares about defending his hometown from any invaders, whether be it the Romans, the Carthaginians, or the Greeks. The siege starts at the western gate, and we see the Roman army with their full power and equipment in front of the fort preparing to attack. As they are loading their catapult, Archimedes' invention kicks in and starts decimating the Romans faster than they can react. And once again, the Syracuse defense bests the Roman attempt to break in with Archimedes' help. After this victory, General Epicutes is basking in the glory of his alleged victory, and he got what he wanted. What he really, really wanted. People are now giving him the title of Hannibal of Syracuse. While the celebration for victory is happening, Epicutes sent his soldiers to take away and kidnap all the Romanian or anyone with Romanian descending from Syracuse, as he kidnaps Claudia from Archimedes' place. Damippus could not stand this, and he faced Epicutes about it. The general ignored him, he was having none of it, and dismissed his case because he is not a true, pure Syracusian. Man, this pure race thing is a big problem, everywhere and all the time. In a trick to make Damippus fight for him, because he is son of Sparta and supposed to be a legendary warrior, he told him to prove himself in a battle, so he will spare the life of Claudia and set her free. This was the setup for the biggest legend of Archimedes in his historic siege battle. which is the use of a big wall of concave mirrors against the Roman fleets. In the manga, Damippus has this idea after seeing one of Archimedes' experiments with concave mirrors. So, he heads back to Archimedes' place to test his theory, as Archimedes helped him to achieve it. On the following day, Damippus gathered all the Syracusans on the shore with mirrors on their hands. And when they saw the Roman fleet, they start reflecting sunlight and concentrating it on several points on the ship until these ships were set on fire one by one. And another great success for Archimedes and his inventions against the Roman Empire. After seeing this, Epicurus has no other choice but to release Clodia after Damippus fulfilled his promise to him. Despite the many failures of the Roman army to break Syracuse defenses, they continued their siege, affecting the morale of Syracusans, their resources, and their supplies. The 300,000 citizens could not handle the stress and the pressure, so their defenses started getting weaker and weaker. Claudia, missing her parents, decided to escape the city and go see them at their camp in Leontini. However, while escaping with Damippus, she is hit by an arrow by mistake while rowing to Leontini. The Romans take her and they attempt to treat her and save her life, but it's too late and she dies without knowing the true fate of her parents. Affected by the siege and the loss of his friend, Damippus makes a deal with the Sword of Rome and shows him a weak spot in the city's defenses on one condition, that he spares the civilians and Archimedes' life. The city finally falls. Soldiers head to Archimedes' house, where he just had a breakthrough in calculating the constant of the circle. Archimedes was rude to them, so they end up killing him. That's how the story ends, in 212 BC, with the fall of Syracuse and the death of the mathematician Archimedes at the age of 75, murdered by a Roman soldier. After 4 years of fighting, the Sword of Rome Marcus is unable to capture Hannibal and instead suffer a humiliating defeat at his hand. However, the Roman Empire ultimately emerges victorious in the war by defeating Carthage and baiting Hannibal into crushing defeats despite his earlier success and close proximity conquering the capital, Rome. Many myths and stories surround Archimedes' life and inventions, especially in relation to his role in wars, and the tale of his many inventions topping the Roman in Syracuse siege. Likewise, there is also confusion about the circumstances of his death, with some accounts claiming he died in a bathtub, and others stating he died while drawing circles in the street, while he was trying to calculate pi accurately. Despite these legends, one thing is certain. Archimedes' remaining work, including the measurement of the circle, sphere, and the cylinder, as well as Archimedes' screw, that is still used in agriculture today, served as one of the foundations for the modern civilization. His legacy continues and will stand the test of time. I hope you enjoyed this tale. I know this is not a happy ending, but it shows that math can and will kill you. Subscribe for more history and manga stories. Thanks for watching. See you soon.